Hi, Kapamilya! I'm TJ Manotok with some of the day's biggest headlines from BA.
Chants like these went on all day Friday as nurses picketed outside San Leandro Hospital. Among them was Filipino registered nurse Ashley Stella. She, along with other Filipino nurses at San Leandro and Alameda Hospitals, said they joined the strike for the safety of their patients and co-workers. They claim there are not enough nurses hired for each unit to adequately care for their number of patients.
You only have 1 to 4, and the medical surgical 1 to 5. But since sometimes we're short-staffed, we mix. That's not good for patients.
Stella is a member of the California Nurses Association, or CNA, which has been negotiating with the Alameda Health System for the past 10 months. The union, which represents over 400 nurses at both locations, said it is suing the hospitals for failing to bargain in good faith. The nurses' union hopes they sent a clear message to management and pledged to go on strike again if management does not budge.
We don't like to go on strike, but we can't let what's happening continue to happen. And we've had unfair labor practices, and that has to stop. That's not okay.
According to KCBS Radio, in a statement, the Alameda Health System said it is committed to the patients and is taking all appropriate steps to minimize the effect of the strike on patient care. From Pampanga, Philippines to Los Angeles, California, hundreds of Kapampangans recently gathered at the Cathedral of Our Lady of the Angels for the Virgen de los Remedios Mass, celebrating the 63rd canonical coronarian anniversary of the devotion. Los Angeles is believed to be the first archdiocese in the country to bring the Kapampangan tradition stateside. And for the devotees, they said it brings miracles.
Very helpful for everything that we ask. She's always trying to help us as much as she can.
The Virgen de los Remedios made its way into Pampanga in the 1950s when Bishop Cesar Maria Guerrero revived the devotion to ease tensions over a communism threat in the region. This year's prayer intentions are still calling for peace, this time for persecuted priests. Earlier this year, the Philippine National Police charged 8 clergymen with sedition, along with other opposition leaders. Last month, the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines also held the National Day of Prayer for the accused clergymen.
Because of what's going on in the Philippines, you know, with the conflict between the state and the church, we're here praying for reconciliation, we're praying for peace, we pray that there's a mutual understanding and respect between the government officials and the hierarchy, the Catholic hierarchy, and that the two institutions work together to bring peace.
We're keeping connected to news that matters most, so be sure to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. I'm TJ Manotok. We'll see you again later today with another BA News.